Hey guys, this is Matt Kaur from ctrl+paint.com, and in today's video we're going to talk a little bit more about how to use custom brushes in a workflow. And this time I'm going to take a totally opposite approach, because if you remember the last video, it was all about shape, using the brush as a silhouette. Well, if you look at this example, the shape is pretty simple, but the rendering on the inside, the way it transitions from light to dark, is much more complex. It's sort of textural. And I'll tell you that I used this brush to create that effect. But as a quick reminder, if you look below the post, you'll find links for free brushes and worksheets, as well as in-depth premium series available in the ctrl+paint store. So it's a bit challenging because this brush, as you can see, has a really crazy silhouette. So if I set off to paint the example, I might have a little trouble controlling it. I'll have a lot of trouble getting that sharp edge. So this is where using custom brushes as an overlay can be really useful. So here you can see I painted the basic shape with a standard brush. I used a hard round, and then I erased it away a bit. And to apply that textural rendering over top, I'll make a new layer, and then I'll say Layer, Create Clipping Mask. And now when I paint with that crazy custom brush that has a lot of randomness to it, I'm not able to go outside of these lines. So I can paint and paint, and I'm restricted to painting only over top of this layer. That's what a clipping mask does. So here, I can sort of restrain that brush a little bit. And I get the best of both worlds. Within the boundaries, I get a nice random look. But then when it comes up to that edge, I get a nice restrained edge. And you can see when I turn off the clipping mask, I've really been painting way outside of the lines. But when it's a clipping mask, you can never tell. So here I've drawn a metal helmet with some leather straps. And this is a great opportunity to use textural overlays because there's two very different materials in the object. And I've got the leather straps on their own layer. So I can make a new layer on top of that, make it a clipping mask, and then I can paint in some of that texture specularity. And I'll use a textured custom brush for this. But because of the way the clipping mask works, I don't have to worry about painting outside of those lines. So I can get the nice randomness of that texture and erase if I want to, but not worry about going outside of the lines. Or if I were to flatten all these layers together, I can make a clipping mask for this entire helmet and paint a little wear and tear over the whole thing. Just rough it up a little bit. And once again, I don't have to worry about going outside the lines, even if the brush has a bit of randomness to it, because the underlying layer is helping to define my edge of that shape. So to get the most out of a custom brush, remember that it can be used in a variety of different ways, whether you want to use it for its shape or use it for its texture as an overlay. If you do a bit of abstract thinking, you can get a lot of interesting usage out of your custom brushes. And if you've never made your own brush, you have no idea what you're missing. So make sure to look out for the Custom Brush Design series, which will be in the store very soon. Thanks for watching, guys.